for the work that you have done and for what you're doing. And open house is very important.
Hello, my name is Dennis Donkin from Lewiston. I want to support the first two speakers. Trinity County is way behind the 21st century when it comes to disability issues. I don't know what that means, but I believe with the first speaker, I can't imagine you going to an open house when you have these critical mass of people here ready to participate. The essence of democracy is a dialogue. And these people are here for a dialogue and you want to go to an open house. I think that's shameful.
Adrian Peterson, Weaverville. I was actually going to say something similar to Ms. Steele. Thank you for your work for the community as a board. My concern as a parent with children in this district is mostly as a way, how are we going to move forward and what are we going to do now?
Rosalind Morris, Weaverville, well, like Trinity Center in California, sorry about that. I really am in the dark. I remember, this is a throwback to OJ when he was racing down the freeway and did something. And I was like, what? I feel like I'm really in the dark, but what I want to say is this. We cannot rely on two people to be the change we want to see. And I will quote Gandhi, we must be the change we want to see in our district, in our community, and in our world. And to think that two individuals are responsible for bringing us down, I've never had that experience. When I have an idea to make things better, I've never had anyone shut me down. So my failures, I'm not going to outsource to someone else. So I say, all right, we're in a difficult situation, but please, let's look at what we want to come of this, and I will tell you right now, the answer is not hiring the next right or wrong person. It's us and what we do.
Tom Barnett, Weaverville. Thank you, Terry and Jennifer. I really, when Jennifer spoke, that's when I feel I need to reply. My daughter, for the last 2.5 years, has been put through quite a bit from Mr. Anderson and Mr. Barnett. They both did some pretty horrendous things, as far as I'm concerned. And she felt like she couldn't be on this campus. And she was either homeschooling or going to College Connection, which was a good experience, but I think the reason that she went was not good. And that was to not be here, where Anderson and Barnett were constantly harassing her. I don't think it's appropriate for certain, I'm sorry for personnel issues, but there's what it is. I don't like the thought of Jennifer and other kids like her not looking forward to being back at school. My daughter did not feel that she could be here comfortably, and I think that's shameful. I think it's shameful that she looks at her high school years as some of the worst years of her life. I look back, and I left high school, and I always think of those as some of the best years of my life. And I think it's terrible that my daughter is going to think of it as the time that she couldn't wait to get through, because it's horrible. And, you know, the thought that I was going to leave Weaverville, and leave a place that she loves everything else about it, except coming to high school. I hope that things can change, whatever it takes, that things can change so that other kids can have different experience, so that kids like Jennifer can enjoy high school. I think it's really important that kids can come to school and feel safe. That's huge. Feeling safe at school is so important. And I know your job is difficult, and I really appreciate what all of you are doing. I feel bad that I did not come to you when my problems were occurring. I didn't feel like I could safely. Unfortunately, with the job that I'm in, if things didn't work out, both of those men could have made my life more difficult, mine and my daughter's, and I just couldn't do that. So I feel for you guys for what's ahead of you and what's on your plate. And I thank you for serving the public.
Hi, I'm Thea Fletcher from Weaverville, and I just want to say thank you to the board for everything that they do, because we all realize that it's a lot of work. So thank you.
Anyone else? All right. We have a little discussion here. We'd like to skip item 9, the whole consent agenda, because we do need to go back in closed session first. So we're going to skip over to item 10, which will be presentations. And the first one is, thank you. Vice President, keeping me straight. So we have a motion for our first, second, all in favor. Aye. All right, item 10.1, ASB presentation, Dora.
All right, my name is Dora Guyman. I'm the ASB representative. So I'll just report on some things that happened in high school recently. FBLA went to their state competition, and Allie Dunham placed in the top 10 of her event. Skills USA also went to state. Jacob Graham placed first in the competition. FFA went to state. They placed first as a team and had several high-scoring individuals as well. Both AP and non-AP government classes had their moot court where they responded to questions from other people in the community about government. This week and next week are the AP testing weeks. We so far have had psych, Spanish language, English literature, U.S. government, and environmental science. Tomorrow is U.S. history, and then all of next week as well. Prom is also this Saturday. Juniors are putting that on. It's Hollywood themed, so we'll see. High schoolers, buy your tickets if you haven't. So track is going to their league meet in Durham tomorrow, and divisions in Durham the next week. And then baseball, softball, and golf have all concluded their seasons. I know golf, for one, was a learning year. They'll be better next year. Next week, we have our moving up week, which is like an intro to high school for all the incoming freshmen, all 8th graders from the feeder schools. We'll be having our move-up assembly on Thursday and our open house that following night. The week will be full of dress-up days and lunch games to get student involvement. For the seniors, scholarship night is on May 23rd to announce the scholarships for their next year. Academic awards for this spring semester will be May 30th. And we have a blood drive May 18th.
Thanks, Sarah. That was great. All right. 10.2 is Julie Fleener here. Oh, there you are. Julie is retiring. After 18 years, we thank you very much for your service. And Tim Hankard is also retiring, and I don't believe he's here. And he's been here 19 years. 10.3, Jamie Green.
Faith had a target at 101 yards, so I mouth off to her in less than 100. But she said she was still in my shot. So she's also started an archery club at our school, which is very popular, and just doing a wonderful job. So congratulations, national champion. We have a young man here tonight that worked very hard and wanted to do this for a long time. And as a Trinity Wolf, we're extremely proud of him. Zachary Wayne Thurman will be attending the United States Naval Academy. The Record Searchlight each year recognizes the top male and female academic athlete in the entire Record Searchlight area, which I believe is over 20 schools. There's never been a school that has been able to have both students honored in that. This year, Trinity High School had Ms. Dara Guyman, female and top athlete. And Mr. Brian Harper is a top male athlete. Our kids are awesome, you guys. Okay, the next two, their advisors are going to come up. We have some other state champions here, which is pretty awesome. Mr. York is going to come up and present his student, Skills USA. First time ever in this school, every time in this county, we had a state champion. And this young man's also fixing my boat. I should get a discount for this, but here we go.
Okay, Skills USA, so it's similar to FFA, FBLA. We work as part of it in lots of different areas. And Jacob Brain, come on down. He took first place in regionals, and we went to Southern California, and he took first place in state.
And for our next state champions, we're going to have our ag teachers come up, Noah and Jenny, and they're going to present these certificates to our state champion forestry team, who will be going to Indianapolis, and we'll probably be fundraising. So if you guys could help us with that, we'd love it. Here you go.
Good evening. So as Jamie said, my name is Noah Corp. This is Jenny Mullen. We're the ag teachers here at the high school. So this year we had an amazing group of students that participated in the FFA forestry competition. And essentially, for those of you who don't know, what that is a forestry industry skills-based contest. So these students spend a whole lot of time learning how to cruise timber, scale logs, use a compass, read maps, and a whole lot of other skills that go along with this. There's actually six different parts of this competition, and these students have worked really, really hard. I've got a couple of different stats for you just really quickly. So we attended 9 different events this year. We traveled 3,410 miles. We have practiced 94 hours of scheduled practice time outside of class. That's pretty amazing that these kids are that dedicated, in addition to time spent on their own. With regard to the state competition, we went down to San Luis Obispo. We competed against 13 other teams. These teams are made up of 4 members. This is highly competitive. It's a complicated contest, and so a lot of schools don't participate because it's so complicated. So again, kudos to those guys for participating in that. Out of those 13 schools that participated, we are the smallest. Okay, and we're competing against schools that are really, really big. This is how it played out. So I'm going to call each of them down. and then Jenny can give them their certificate here. So we were the first high team. So we were the state finalists, first high team in the state. We beat the second high team by 150 points out of 1,350. Okay? So that's really awesome. We also just about swept the entire contest. So Dylan Miller, if you can come down. He is a hot individual in the state. So not only did we win, but he was the high individual in the state. Hunter Cloud, who is not able to be here tonight, he is at work, was second high individual in the state and was only second high individual by 1 point behind Dylan. And I'll say really quickly, so Dylan's been on this team for 3 years. Hunter's been on this team for 3 years. Jay Stockwell, fourth high individual in the state. Been on this team for 2 years. And then 11th high individual in his first year. Pretty amazing, Connor Cloud. So again, a big round of applause to these guys and their parents. This is a huge commitment. They're doing awesome things. Like Tammy said, we'll be heading to the national competition on October 24th in Indianapolis. So look forward to what might happen there. We're hopeful. So thank you very much.